Welcome to a discussion about scientific proofs and the controversies between the mass media and the scientific community. The disagreements are particularly confrontational in the field of archaeology because archaeology is not a hard science like chemistry or physics. The Encyclopedia Britannica says that although archaeology uses extensively the methods, techniques, and results of the physical and biological sciences, it is not a natural science. Some consider it a discipline that is half science and half humanity. Perhaps it is more accurate to say that the archaeologist is first a craftsman, practicing many specialized crafts, of which excavation is the most familiar to the general public, and then a historian. Hard science is the term used to define natural and physical sciences that study the universe through theories, hypotheses, and experiments. The scientific method starts by observing natural phenomena and forming a hypothesis that explains the observations. The hypothesis is then tested by experiments that can confirm or reject the hypothesis. The most important requirement of the scientific method is that a hypothesis should be testable. If a hypothesis cannot be tested, then it is not considered a scientific hypothesis. An example of the controversies between geology and archaeology is provided by the study of water erosion by Professor Robert Schock in the enclosure of the Great Sphinx in Egypt. The Wikipedia article about Robert Schock says, quote, Schock is best known for his fringe argument that the Great Sphinx of Giza is much older than conventionally thought and that some kind of catastrophe was responsible for wiping out evidence of a significantly older unknown civilization. In 1991, Schock redated the monument to 10,000 to 5,000 BC based on water erosion marks he identified on the Sphinx enclosure walls and also based on findings from seismic studies around the base of the Sphinx and elsewhere on the plateau. The Sphinx water erosion hypothesis is rejected by the archaeological community because of evidence contradicting his conclusions. End quote. The view held by modern Egyptology continues to be that the Great Sphinx was built in approximately 2500 BC for Pharaoh Khafre. Notice that the Wikipedia article refers to Schock's contribution as a fringe hypothesis. These demeaning characterizations are frequently applied to ideas that differ from the general consensus. Many scientific and archaeological topics are discussed on the internet. On YouTube, you can find Randall Carlson discussing the Egyptian priests who knew America. Jimmy Corsetti from Bright Insight discusses the lost city of Atlantis, and Johanna James dedicates her channel to ancient technologies. In the summer of 2023, many of these internet personalities will be making presentations in a conference called the Cosmic Summit in Nashville, North Carolina. The conference will cover a wide variety of topics that are considered controversial by the scientific community. The streaming platform Netflix currently features a series with journalist Graham Hancock as he travels the globe hunting for evidence of mysterious lost civilizations dating back to the last ice age. The Netflix series highlights many of the topics that have been discussed in Graham's books, where he presents physical evidence and discusses academic studies indicating that there may have been advanced civilizations before the Younger Dryas Cataclysm at the end of the ice age. In a tweet posted on December 1, 2022, the Society for American Archaeology, SAA, launched an attack against Graham Hancock's Netflix series. The Society for American Archaeology said, quote, "Archaeologists devote their lives and careers to researching and sharing knowledge about the past with the public. Netflix's Ancient Apocalypse undermines trust in their work and aligns with racist ideologies. Read SSA's letter to Netflix outlining concerns." End quote. The tweet provides a link to the letter. The tweet from the Society for American Archaeology claims that the Netflix series aligns with racist ideologies, which is a defamatory accusation. If you click on the reply button to try to make a comment, you find out that only people at SAA.org can reply. This is a cowardly way of making defamatory statements and blocking replies and counterarguments. The letter from the Society for American Archaeology to Netflix says, quote, "We have three principal concerns with regard to Ancient Apocalypse. One, The host of the series, who is Graham Hancock, repeatedly and vigorously dismisses archaeologists and the practice of archaeology with aggressive rhetoric, willfully seeking to cause harm to our membership and our profession in the public eye. 2. Netflix identifies and advertises the series as a docu-series, a genre that implies its content is grounded in fact when the content of the show is based on false claims about archaeologists and archaeology. And 3. The theory it presents has a long-standing association with racist, white supremacist ideologies, does injustice to indigenous peoples, and emboldens extremists. End quote. This third accusation against Graham Hancock's proposal that there were some survivors of the Younger Dryas Cataclysm is basically a smear campaign intended to prevent potential viewers from watching the Netflix series. Anybody who has met Graham Hancock and his wife, Santa Faia, who is an accomplished photographer, knows that Graham Hancock could not harbor or support racist or white supremacist ideologies. The members of the Society for American Archaeology should be ashamed that the RPA president, Daniel H. Sandweiss, stooped so low in drafting and signing this scurrilous letter, which actually harms the reputation of the Archaeological Society more than anything that Hancock said. The use of ad hominem attacks by Sandweiss on behalf of the Society for American Archaeology corrupts the reputation of archaeology. The letter from the Society for American Archaeology continues. Our efforts to combat pseudo-archaeology are not new. Archaeologists have published extensively on the flaws of unscientific theories and the dangers they pose, including several recent media interviews, opinion pieces, and social media posts addressing specific content from this show. Popular television series such as Ancient Aliens on the History Channel have promoted false claims about the ancient past for many years. These claims frequently rob indigenous peoples of credit for their cultural heritage. The SAA letter refers to the ancient astronaut theorists from the History Channel who are constantly proposing that historical texts, archaeology, petroglyphs, and legends contain evidence that intelligent extraterrestrial beings visited the Earth in ancient times and interacted with human cultures. This is pure fantasy without any supporting evidence, but the ideas are proposed with a straight face as if they were facts, and many people who trust the History Channel now believe in ancient aliens. The letter from the Society for American Archaeology says that the Netflix series Ancient Apocalypse is more harmful than Ancient Aliens. It not only disparages the cultures of indigenous peoples, but also carries the harm a step further by disparaging archaeologists. The combative tone of Graham Hancock damages the public's perception of archaeology. Clearly, the Society for American Archaeology is going through a crisis, but it is not Graham Hancock's fault. The Society wants to control the information that is disseminated to the public, but such control is impossible today when there are so many voices on the mass media. What is wrong with archaeology? Why is a geological study of water erosion in the sphinx enclosure by Professor Schock called the fringe hypothesis? Modern humans have been around for 200,000 years, so why is Graham Hancock's suggestion of a civilization 13,000 years ago considered impossible? It seems that archaeologists have an inferiority complex, and they must assert their authority when a new idea is suggested in order to maintain their accepted narrative. By contrast, astronomers welcome new observations, even from amateurs. Astronomers don't disparage amateurs who discover new comets by calling them pseudo-astronomers. On the contrary, a new comet gets named after its discoverer, regardless of whether he or she was a professional astronomer or not. The Society for American Archaeology is concerned about how the public perceives archaeology. But the real problem is that archaeology is not a hard science or natural science. Archaeology is a craft that enables us to study the past by interpreting clues obtained from various disciplines. People with different perspectives may reach different conclusions from the same clues, so it is inevitable that archaeological opinions will always be contested. The Society for American Archaeology may continue to combat what they call pseudo-archaeology and fringe hypotheses, but as the sources of opinions proliferate through the mass media, this will become an impossible task. The genie is out of the bottle, and the SAA will not be able to be the gatekeeper of information. I hope that the Society for American Archaeology will stop the practice of besmirching people, which reflects very badly on the society and its leadership. This is not what a responsible professional society should do. Thank you for joining me in this discussion about the interpretation of physical evidence. I am glad that geology is a hard science in which experiments can be performed to test ideas. Unlike archaeological excavations that cannot be replicated and depend on interpretation, geology allows us to conduct reproducible experiments showing that oblique impacts by ice projectiles on viscous ground produce inclined conical cavities that become shallow elliptical depressions by viscous relaxation. This is a valuable model that can be used to explain the elliptical geomorphology of the Carolina Bays. My book about the Carolina Bays is available at Amazon. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays and other scientific topics.